ALVR is now available on the Vision Pro App Store, which, if you haven't seen my two videos on it already, is a software that lets you stream PCVR games to any standalone headset, in this case the Vision Pro. When I talked about it previously, it was only available on test flight, but now you can just freely download it on the App Store. A lot of cool new features have been added since the last time we've talked about it, so let's jump into it and see what the developers have been cooking up. If you've ever used something like Virtual Desktop on the Meta Quest, then this is basically the same setup process. This being a wireless connection to your PC, the quality of your stream depends on your Wi-Fi signal quality and how close you are to your router. Even with a good internet connection though, my experience with it is pretty spotty. 2 months ago, the resolution was actually pretty good, but now it's a lot blurrier even when I bump up the resolution settings. I don't have these type of performance issues with Virtual Desktop, so I doubt it's my internet. Your mileage for all of this may vary though. The Vision Pro doesn't come with controllers, so instead everything is controlled with your hands. And now that Apple has updated the Vision Pro hand tracking to 90Hz, games like VRChat and Beat Saber are really playable. I will say it's not as great as Virtual Desktop on the Quest since ALVR's hand tracking is jittery, but it is enough for games that don't require quick movements like VRChat. For movement, you have to pretend you're holding a joystick, which is actually kinda cool when it recognizes a gesture, and really annoying when it doesn't. Lighting is very important for it though, so keep that in mind. With the introduction of VisionOS 2 at WWDC, we get a ton of new features that ALVR now supports. The coolest thing is room scale support. Previously, you could only walk around a 13x13 foot circle before your view became transparent. Now you can walk infinitely, although the floor still turns transparent, which is still weird, but better than not having anything, so I guess it's fine. The refresh rate has been updated to 100Hz, adding 10 more hertz from the previous limit of 90. There's also a new experimental toggle that allows for a higher resolution, but in my experience, it either doesn't work or doesn't work well. I'm sure with future updates we'll see performance with it improving significantly. Anyways, that's all for today. Make sure to like and subscribe for more horrible Beat Saber gameplay just like this one. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and take care!